go. All right. Danny, now the Oscars are coming. Will you you and Susan watch the Oscars? Do y'all have a party Sunday night or what?
I actually, doggone it, I've got to go do some work. I've got to be out of town, but I'll be in a hotel watching it Sunday night.
Now, people up there, the Oscar movies, how many of these people have you worked with, basically, that will be in attendance?
A bunch. I even know some seat fillers up there. Yeah.
Is that true, like the Seinfeld episode?
Yeah.
When Kramer gets in a seat?
Yeah, yeah. And they're up rehearsing today and tomorrow.
Seat fillers have to rehearse?
Yeah, they do. They have to kind of have a little. Terry Minton up in Nashville, and she'll probably get me for saying her name, but yes, she's...
Now, have you ever been a seat filler?
No, never have. Never have.
Now, that means, they saw me the other day, when Eddie Murphy did not win the Oscar for the movie he had years ago, he got mad and left.
Uh-oh.
They're saying when most people don't win, they leave.
Well, now, that's no way...
And that's when the seat fillers come in.
Yeah, that's it. I don't know if I've ever told you, but I've had a little encounter with Oscar. We did a movie... a short movie called Two Soldiers back in, golly, I guess it was 2005 or 4, I guess. Well, that they have a category, short film, live action.
Yeah.
And we won the Oscar, and so there was a 12-member cast, and I was in it. So we got to have a party and hold old Oscar. And,
really?
Yeah.
Did you get to go to any of the other after Oscar parties?
No. That was kind of a closed
deal.
All
right, do you know what is on opposite the Oscars Sunday night that you have a relationship with?
Uh-oh. Well, it could be one of my movies. I don't know.
TV hit The Walking Dead.
Walking Dead, okay, yeah.
Now, you were in The Walking Dead, but you got killed off.
Right. One episode.
Yeah, just
there you are, right there.
The governor gets me. Yeah. Season 4, episode 6.
Now, do you ever make predictions on Oscar? Is Sniper going to take it off?
It's going to do well. There'll be a surprise or two. There always is, and that's what really I like to watch, that in the commercials and the and also too. You're right. I have worked with a lot of these.
Reese Witherspoon being one. Mm-hmm. She won an Oscar for Walk the Line.
Yes.
Now
she did.
You were in that movie.
Uh huh. Yeah. Yeah. I didn't mess it up for her.
Now, how many Oscar movies have you been in?
Three. Three
Walk
movies that have won Walk the Line, Benjamin Button, and The Two Soldiers that
we
I
haven't mentioned. Even seen Benjamin Button.
No. Yeah, but that's a great movie. It's F. Scott Fitzgerald, just an unbelievable story.
Do you ever walk out of something like that after y'all done a rap? I know the lingo.
Yeah.
And just on the drive back, whatever you say, I cannot believe I just worked with Robert Redford, Bobby Duvall, or somebody like that.
Well, yeah, a lot. It's
and then I get to work with Jamie Cooper in the morning.
I get up early and have to fight the snow?
I'm living the dream. I really, I do have to kind of, my dad gave me some very, very good advice before he passed away, and I can't repeat it. I will off screen to you what he told me just how to manage these.
You've been doing this 20 years, practically.
Yep.
I don't know, I may have asked you this before, but I don't seem to remember it right now.
They put their pants on just like you do every morning.
That's just about what he said.
Why did you decide to say, I think I can be an actor?
Well, I don't know. People ask me all the time.
I mean, you don't necessarily stand out like a turd in a punch bowl.
No. Well, thank you. I guess that's a compliment.
But apparently, he does have a character.
It's something that I kind of backed into, and I think because of it, nobody ever heard me say growing up that I wanted to be an actor.
Right.
Nothing against the profession; it's a very noble profession, I feel, but it's. You can't do that from where we live, you know? You just don't think of it.
You don't think people in Alabama are going to be in big movies.
Well, no, and so you don't try. You don't pursue it. You don't, L.A. or New York, and I'm staying here, you know? Well, I was a marketer, marketing major, and did that for like 18 years. And suddenly the situation just kind of... I'm pretty sure I was led into this. I was guided into this.
What was the first thing you ever auditioned for?
A Goodies department store commercial in Nashville, and I got it. And it was, I think, paid $300 or something like that. And I thought, well, this is easy. This is like crap.
So you were basically stepping out of a comfort zone.
I just
go and shoot for something like
that. I never have been uncomfortable doing it. It's really, I never have really had to, I've had some bad things happen, and you know, you have to watch this business, it'll get you. But for me, it was just, I didn't know what I was doing when I started, And so I just kind of kept fumbling and stumbling and finding my way, and it led to certain things. And then I realized and was given some very good advice to make sure you sell them a little extra. And when I started doing that, that's when I started working. And I worked these big movies. And one big movie led to another big movie. And then all of a sudden, they all came to the South, and my timing couldn't have been better. And I've been in 19 states since 95 working.
And if people want to learn some acting tricks from you and everybody else, all they got to do is go to Hollywood Huntsville.
We can teach them, yeah. And anything. It's whatever level you want to do it. If you want to do community theater, if you want to do just commercials, if you want to just do voiceover work, that's, you know, there are agents just only for that stuff. Let's say you want to be a hand double or a body double.
Which you were a hand double.
Do you get credit for hand double?
I took credit for it early on. I did a lot of hand double, body double.
Hold your hands up. You were McConaughey's hand double in
Time to Kill.
Time to Kill.
Yep, all of his close-up stuff. It was
your hand. Now, do you get credit for that then?
No.
I know, I wondered, are you in the credits for a time?
No, they don't give you that.
But what makes your hands any better looking than mine?
Well,
they must look like McConaughey's.
Ben Nye Jr. was doing makeup on that movie, the old famous Ben Nye, the old famous actor, makeup artist. And he came around one day looking at everybody's hands.
Get out!
No. He came twice to me. And I have guitar picks that I have to kind of trim down, but... he came back that afternoon, grabbed my hand, he said, can you cut those? I said, yeah. He said, okay, you win. And I said, I win what? He said, you get to do Matthew's hands.
And why couldn't he do his own hands?
He's off there shooting something else, and I'm over here with the second unit doing
hands. Yeah. On his time. Yeah.
You see what y'all learned from this program?
How about that? Now,
so most of the times that you see a big actor and they may show some parts of their body, it may not necessarily be them.
No, yeah, it's some. It could be an extra, or it could be somebody, you know, like myself. Just he was doing math at his desk. He disarmed a bomb. What else did we do? I can't remember. But
it's been so long ago.
Yeah, it was.
What Ashley Judd looked like sweating.
Ashley Judd was a blonde during those days, and she.
That's the sweatiest movie I've ever seen.
Sprayed on sweat.
Her and Matthew McConaughey were dating when I got there.
Oh, really? August.
Yeah, and then when she wrapped and left, come December, he and Sandy Bullock were hooking up. So there he is. So it was. I thought, well, yeah.
All right, Danny, thanks for coming up here, man. Danny Benson. Maybe nominated for an Oscar before long. You never know. Already won one.
We shall try. We shall do our best.
Put a good plug for me next time you're on the red carpet.
I'll do it.
All right, we got to take a break. We'll see y'all bright and early tomorrow. If it ain't too cold, you won't see me here. All right, we'll see y'all. Bye.